Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today we are going to show you how to look up the value in a row using the VLOOKUP function. So by the end of this video, you should be able to take the value in this cell right here, look up that value in column A, and follow over on the row and return what is in column C in this cell right here.
Also, we will have some additional training options for you at the end of this video, so stick around for that.
So in order to do this, we are going to use what is known as the VLOOKUP function. So if I click in F2 and I type equals VLOOKUP with a left parenthesis, the first argument I'm going to be prompted for is the lookup value. And the lookup value I want to look up is right here in cell F1. So I'm just going to click F1 and then type a comma. My next argument is table array. And what that means is, where is all of the data where I'm going to be doing this lookup? Not just where I'm going to be looking up the name here, but all of the data that I wish to return. So that is going to be in columns A through C. So I'm just going to click on column A, hold my left mouse button down, and drag over to column C. Now, one very important thing to note when using the VLOOKUP function is that the column where I am doing the lookup, in this case, it's the sales rep, that has to be to the left of the value that I wish to return. And the lookup value has to be in the first column that I've selected for my table array, which in this case is going to be column A. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos. So after I put in my table array, I'm going to type a comma. Now my next argument is column index number. And that is, once I find my value, how many columns do I wish to go over? And I want to go over 1, 2, 3 columns. So I'm going to type the number 3. And then I'm going to type a comma. And the final argument is range lookup. Now that is asking me whether or not I want an exact match or a partial match. If I want a partial match, I'm going to put true here or a 1. But in this case, I want an exact match, so I'm going to type a 0. And then I'm going to close my parentheses and hit enter. And you can see that I'm being returned with 81747. Which, if I look in this row, is Tom, and it is 81747. So if I go up here and I change this to Ed, I can see that I am now being returned with the value right here in C2, because the match is being done on the sales rep in F1. There are many, many different ways to use this VLOOKUP function, and we go over all of those on our blog. I'm going to include a link to that blog entry in the description below on YouTube in case you would like to go there and learn a lot more about VLOOKUP. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them for us and we'll get back to you. Thanks for watching and see you again next time. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.